All right, so I was scrolling through a couple of the cars, and I was looking at some stuff that I really like for cars just because of the nature of the vehicle, what it is, and how unpopular that it is. I know that's an odd reason to like a vehicle, but that is a reason that I like this set of six cars that I'm going to drive around the Nurburgring. We are going to start with the Pantera. The Pantera is such a sick vehicle to me. European design. Big old huge V8 from America and handles poorly. Now, I've blacked everything out. See those bumpers, the lower chin spoiler, all of that stuff was a different color. But going into the livery editor gives me a chance to go knock that out. Just murder everything, chrome the factory wheels, and we just got a sick ass Pantera now with that possibility of blacking everything out. Listen to that. Sounds so sweet. So to begin the video of the day, of course, we're gonna knock off this information from the screen. I don't need any of that. Okay, sweet, good. That is gone. All I need is what I can see for gauges. That definitely seems like we're super far away. And this is on sport mediums. Such a nice car. Real big vehicle. Lightweight keeping up. Well, you gonna let me by? Sick. I'll take that. A lot of weight in the rear end. I do not want this thing swinging around. But look at this interior. Super stitched craftsmanship. Good stuff all through here. The gauges, they are okay. Steering wheel kind of blocks it. If the steering wheel had a little bit of a bigger diameter, then it would be a lot better in my book. The wheel. Damn, I don't know. Is that like an old school Momo? This thing floating. It handles fairly good if we're not trying to get too rapid. Float a little bit. The mirror has good visibility right there in that port window. We are riding. Let me just hold it here and forth. We got the limiter. Man, that's a good corner. That V8 sounds sick behind us. Just running this thing. I like that the dashboard is so minimal. Everything is so far forward. Breaking down. Everything so far forward in this car. The force feedback is very heavy, very weighted. Really makes you feel like you're just in an old ass car. Look at those floor mats. Sick ass custom floor mats. Taking a leisure drive around here. Just enjoying the car for what it is. It's a sick ass car. I would really like one of these. Between this and a BMW 1M. One of the more modern ones. Not the too modern rounded one, but maybe a couple years up from this, like a 75. Feels like I'm sitting so low in this thing. And those are just lap belts? Oh my God.
big tall hill. The torque is hella good. Look at that, just climbing this hill. It's really strange that the radio sits sideways like that. Wouldn't be able to blast my MC Hammer without it skipping. Having it to get really fast around the track. I'm just going. And we're already to the carousel. This has been a nice, calm, leisure drive. This is sick. This is really the way to enjoy this game in these cars. Not trying to push it, not trying to get a lap time, just literally enjoying the car. On one of the biggest tracks in the game. Afternoon drive, and at this point of performance, driving the car this casually, it really feels like this is the spot it's supposed to be in. If you push this car a little bit harder, I'm sure it may respond well with tuning, but this isn't tuned and it's just super comfortable. It's good enough to be quick, it's stable, and let's see, good brake in here. I get good feel in the steering wheel right now. That was one of my gripes with Gran Turismo, going over bumps and things. You didn't feel too much of anything, but this right here is totally offering me some feedback. Good old cruise. And the last carousel. Now, let's see how fast it'll go. Really gonna push it. See if we can get some speed out of her. Let's see. I think this is a 5-speed, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, yep. It's a dog leg reverse trans, that's sick. She's getting a move on, 140. 4-5. We get 150. Pop-up headlights, coolest cars on the planet come with those. She's shuffling along. And I'm not gonna push it to the limit, I'll roll off right here. Nice ass Sunday drive. turn on the hazard lights. That's that. That was sick as hell. Look at this thing. So sick. Rearview mirror is bugging me though. But here we go. Big V12. Ooh. Ooh. Oh, all of these shapes and just riding in a big ass arithmetic problem. This is really nice, the sound it's making. This is a lot more ass heavy. This carb 12 cylinder does get up and go. Oh, told you it's gonna try and kill me. You know, Lamborghinis really stay true to their form. This narrow-ass windshield has me feeling claustrophobic. And then these shapes on this these side windows are super odd. And I would not be riding the 70s version of a Countach around. 88 for a show, but definitely not the 70s joint. This bad boy is flying, actually. What in the hell? Let me relax and take this corner as I'm supposed to with this ass-heavy car. This dash is a whole lot bigger and weird-looking. Can't really see the gauges too much. Couple of dials and gauges down there. Super minimalist approach with this thing too. That's on accident, but I had to control it. This humongous gated shifter. We are doing work in this big old Bamboni. Likes to oversteer like this. You know, I wonder if it's part of the fact that maybe we would be able to get better handling without really messing with the suspension too much, with being able to get wider tires under this, because I know this vehicle needs at least a 285 or a 305. That would fill out those rear arches a lot better and probably cure some of this oversteer. And that might have been one of the changes that was made going into the second version of the Countach. This is a 72 or 74. And I do believe the version of the 80s had wider tires for sure, on top of aero package. Oh, you better turn, girl. He has a little understeer settle in, but then it just snaps over. And where are the mirrors? This has got no wing mirrors? Suspension is definitely not the business on this, but you do have to realize we are keeping the GT3 RS at bay behind us, so we are doing exceptionally well for the moment. A couple of these corners I really want a left foot brake, but I don't want to fully upset this chassis. Doing more focusing on driving this vehicle than enjoying it like I was enjoying the Pantera. The floorboard is exceptionally high right there. What the hell? Wow. Seats are sick though. Let's get into this carousel. Keep it together. And spill on in there. I feel like I'm driving this more competitively, more fast than the Pantera. But definitely do agree that this may not be as fast. I'm just forced to drive it more in that nature because of how twitchy and shifty it is. But as far as just build design on the car, see how the steering wheel is, the interior of the rim of the wheel allows me to see every gauge, but then the design of the dash and the size of the gauges are so poor you can't really even see the gauge. But at least the steering wheel isn't blocking anything. I like how high the center console is. Myself, I would just be able to rest my arm right there. Oh, shoot. Just don't hit anything. All right. Man, let me focus and drive this thing. I'm not fully enjoying this experience. It is cool nonetheless, but get me out of here. When in doubt, push the clutch in. Just hold it. Figure it out. Left foot braking that just caused some oversteer. Such a challenging car, man. I believe we got around like 153 in the Pantera. Let's see what this scary ass wedge will do. Let's just come off of here riding. So nervous on the steering. Felt like I was about to lose it there. Alright. Can't see anything any damn way. Dang, I cannot see anything. Whatever, we're just running it. Oh man, I do not have the confidence that this is gonna end up well, so I'm just gonna start slowing it down here. Clutch in, because that almost got bad. And this nightmare is over with. Ooh-wee. Scary, scary car to drive. These classic Ferraris look so good, but I have a feeling this might be just as bad to drive as the Countach was. Look at how your pedals are all the way to the center. Revving her out to like 7,300. That Porsche is just trying to show me his boss, but I get it. Wow, it's starting early to get some oversteer. Right, let me just enjoy the drive. Yeah, real heavy weighted wheel, great feel. Yeah, it definitely feels like translating through the steering wheel. That rear end wants to go around. Oh, don't you get off me, buddy. I'm trying to destroy my classic paint. Left foot brake, keep it intact, use the bump, and off we go. this is not an extremely powerful car, and I think that's what I like about it. That ugly old Alpine stereo. What the heck? What the hell is that? That's an old ass radio. Yeah, I see he's bearing down on me in the rear view. Oh man. Bounce the limiter, left foot brake, back on the throttle. Counter steer. Breaker on down. This is a really nice road car. Definitely quick enough to get you in trouble. I'm rolling these gears now. I'm really sending it. I should relax. Definitely should relax. Alright, there we go. A good visibility. I really like the visibility on this car. Windshield, side windows, even those rear port windows that give you a little bit of a wraparound visibility. Really like the visibility in this thing. And looking at apexes and seeing those fender wells, the high bulges of those fender arches is a treat. Got a little bit of oversteer in her. Well, actually a lot. I'm just maintaining it as best I can. Going quickly. All right, get it back together. Little nice crackling pops in the exhaust. Sounds good. Real good, actually. Brake hard, roll out. There we go. Got a little bit of counter going. Huge heel. I'll get enough lap time in here on Nurburgring. I can rival Sabine Schmitz. In when you doubt it. Rolling this huge shifter. Roll those gears. Alright, quick section. Let's go around here and see what we can do. Let's get to the top of fourth. A little bit of roll on oversteer. Looks like it's padding. It almost is inviting for a headbutt and a collision. But the sharp shape of it, I don't know. And the wheel is so close to the dashboard, I feel like your hands would be in danger. Like that, it's just... Definitely would want to have a steering wheel spacer, a hub spacer on that. Just to get the wheel away from the dashboard. Now let's dip into the carousel. Brakes tough. Good on exit. A little bit of wheel spin. That's an exciting way to exit out of there. So good. Motor is not giving me the good vibes as far as auditory pleasures that the Lambo gave and even the Pantera gave, but the performance is good. It's not too torquey, and it actually holds pretty good at the higher RPMs. Nice linear feel, and these cars really feel the same with them having those rear engines and bigger rear engines at that. So they're a little tail happy. Panteras so far still seem more enjoyable. This is pretty good. This is a close second. This is more sporty, I would say. The Pantera was more on the comfortable side. The all-arounder, the do-it-all, the Luigi in the Mario Kart world. This is more sporty and more active. And then the Lamborghini was just terrifying. That lift over steer is a weird one, but it's maintainable. As we come up to this right-hander, I'll just go up it in second. Likes popping out. I think that's just suspension being uneasy with that. Now let's set her up for some speed. Come on around. Okay, kill all the speed. Alright, whatever. Nice bright gauges. Even in the daytime, it's extremely visible. I like it. Taking her right up to 7,300. Braking and gas, there we go. Dunzo. Oh, what a good ride. Dodge Challenger 1970. Look at this huge wheel. Holy crap. Oh, come on. Oh, this wheel is ignorant. Look how much space this is. This is a freaking living room. Oh, it's so floaty. At fourth speed, that is it. It's tipping over. Holy crap. Another equally terrible steering wheel. Gauges are easier to see. Hood again. Let's go. Feel like I'll make it through the track with this. It's definitely, whoa. Handling a lot better. All right. And we should be getting some more cars this week. I think got some updates coming, and from what I spied with my little eye, is an FC3S. Oh, there we go. Got this thing moving along, and it's no fifth gear, so we're backing off. Thing actually almost does not have the power to push it on the limiter, which is a good thing. Here, we're just flat out. Should bounce the limiter now. There we go. So I'd see that antenna right there. This hell of a Aston Martin better back off. Took that almost at the top speed. I would love some old Can-Am cars like this to drive around. That'd be amazing. And the Limited. Long downhill section, just rolling off the throttle just enough to not bounce the Limited. And then back on the throttle up the hill. Big old heavy thing. The Challenger just wasn't cool to drive. Was that a Charger? It was a chest something. RT was not fun to drive. It'd probably be cool with a whole bunch of power and maybe a transmission. This is just low powered enough to be entertaining. And it has some grip. And the motor sounds pretty good. Oh, jeez. This is the same corner we went off at. I guess just all this iron on these things just do not handle that corner politely, I would say. Flashes of oversteer from this thing, but it's mainly handling everything we're throwing at it. Ah, man, I just wish there was a way that they would allow us to do close ratio 5-speed transmissions, which didn't have the huge transmission whine. Still be able to use the clutch. I would for sure add those to the vehicles, but I don't do transmissions simply because I'm not into changing the final wrap, the final drive ratios, and I don't like the transmission whine inside the car because I like to experience, you know, these sounds that you're hearing right here. Oh, we finally got the Limited flat out going up the hill. This thing doesn't have enough horsepower. It's got the torque, not the horsepower. It's getting through there. This almost has the enjoyable feel of the Pantera. Like, it's not a scary drive, even when you're going along quickly, which this is only about 111 miles an hour. Might be a little bit faster because I roll off right close to the Limiter, so I've been known to get a couple more miles an hour out of it. So probably about 114 is about the max speed that we're getting on this car. Sunday cruise. Okay, it's a speed around here now. Comfortable with it. thing covers some ground if you don't bounce it up the limiter. I always like this corner because the rhythm right here, and then you go into the dip and brake hard. It always seems to be a good place to load your suspension. Kinda just gave up on that right there, cause there's nothing left. Just what, do 110 miles an hour for about 2 miles. Alright, let's see the speedo here. Coming up on 80. Oh no, I'm sorry, that's 6,000 RPMs. Yeah, we're doing about 114 right now. 15. About 114-ish. The shifter is the worst. Come on. Oh yeah, that was so boring. I don't even gotta slow this thing down until the last second. Oh god. That was, that headache is done. Woo, look at this. Uh-oh. Well, Jesus Christ, why you got me going against a Veneno? Oh, God, this thing is fast. That's why I'm going against that. Oh, calm your nerves. Wow! Yeah, you get out of my way, because I was going to pass you regardless. This thing is jamming. Can you imagine driving this movie theater this fast? Let's get some speed under it. See what we got. Buck 20. Oh, jeez. No aero on this. This is just big chassis and wide tires, baby. Yeah, baby. Oh, man. I wonder if it's a 6-speed. Oh, man, we're burying the dash already. All right, let me relax. Let me relax. Lamborghinis in sight. Use that grunt. Oh man, this thing is floating. It's breaking right here. I ain't got nothing to prove coming up here. Let's get this thing around this track. Third gear puts down so much velocity, and then fourth gear is just magic. That's the power level. Here go the cruise level. Ooh, ooh. we're spinning forth. Ooh. Spin these shits. I'm getting carried away. This is heavy as hell. It almost didn't want to stop. Get in the dip. Head up. Crest is healed. Sent. Stay off the wall. Alright, we are almost done. Just stay together. Woo-wee! Oh, man. She didn't like that. This suspension isn't really set up to do what it's doing, but... she is a strip vehicle, a cruiser that is going through one of the most grueling tracks on the planet. And again, I could definitely tune this and make it far more capable, but just driving it factory fresh out the box is fun. That's what this is all about right now. She's understanding big. Nice. I like subtle rubber burning. That torque is making it happen. Don't know what just happened. What did I do? Put it in second or something? Oh man, I had to make sure that Lambo ain't coming. I must have accidentally put that in second. That sucks. We were doing so good. We ain't going back now. We just going through. Now we know we're doing buck 60. How much faster? Who knows? Alright, here we go. Oh, it's a 6-speed. This has got to be doing about buck 70. 80 maybe. flying. Suspension cannot handle all that. Oh, get yourself together. Alright. We're done. That's gonna wrap this up. I'm gonna attach all six replays to the tail end of this. So if you just want to see what the cars look like cruising, that's what you're gonna see after this. But that was pretty daggone good. I'm impressed with all of the vehicles. My favorite vehicles as far as driving so far in order. We're gonna start with the Pantera. Pantera was the most fun, most relaxing, most calming, and it was handling its business, going very quick. Then we'll go over to the Mustang. Everything was great until you get to about 110 miles an hour. Then we've got the little bit of the nervous squirrel, twitchy Ferrari. That was good stuff. It was very quick, very exciting, lots of revs. But it didn't give you great engine tone. And then we'll go to the Lambo. Lambo is big, bad, and fast, but will try to kill you, and it's not fun to drive. Then we've got the Nova, and then we go with the Charger. So that's how we do it. First Pantera, second Mustang, third Ferrari BB, fourth Countach, fifth Nova, sixth Challenger. And that's how we're going to wrap that one up today. So we are done, and we'll do another one sometime soon. You heard?
Yeah.